Riaz Akhtari and Ghaus Mohammed, the accused in the brutal murder of Udaipur Taylor, were produced in a special court by the National Investigation Agency on Thursday. Terming the Udaipur murder as an act of terror, the NIA said that some media reports about the links of the two accused with some terrorist outfit are based on speculation. The agency added that the accused wanted to be a hero in the eyes of their community. Meanwhile, Rajasthan Chief Minister Ashok Gehlot held a meeting in Udaipur with officials of the state pertaining to law and order situation over the Udaipur murder incident. At least 8 people were reportedly killed and over 50 are feared missing after a massive landslide hit the camp of 107 Territorial Army Camp in the Noni district of Manipur early on Thursday, according to the officials. Out of the 8 killed, 7 are reported to be Territorial Army Jawans and a labourer of the Indian Railways engaged in the construction of the Imphal Jiribam Railway project. According to the officials, as many as 13 people have been rescued and that the injured are being treated at the Noni Army Medical Unit. Evacuation of the critically injured personnel is also in progress. Shinde faction of the MLAs who are currently staying at a hotel in Goa engaged in celebrations post the announcement made by Devendra Fadnavis. Fadnavis announced in a press conference on Thursday that Eknath Shinde would be sworn in as the new chief minister of the state. This came as a surprise amid all the speculations of Fadnavis becoming the CM for the third time. Fadnavis also added that he would not be a part of the ministry led by Shinde but would support it from outside. Amid incessant rains, a flood-like situation has emerged in Bihar owing to which several rivers like Kosi, Mahananda, Gandak are in spate. In a shocking incident witnessed on Wednesday, villagers who have been residing by the banks of Kosi River in Bhagalpur district demolished their own houses and took away the construction material as the village faced erosion due to the turbulent flow of the flooded river. One villager stated that no politician took cognizance of their grievances and they were forced to destroy their houses and take the remaining materials. He also added that no facilities have been provided by any government amid the flooding of rivers.